Cardiovascular disease is the largest single cause of death in modern societies. Interestingly, in the last century, rates of cardiovascular disease were decreasing due to reduced rates of smoking and better treatment of high blood pressure. The diabetes and obesity epidemic has turned this around, and cardiovascular disease is increasing in the community at the moment. The major underlying cause of cardiovascular disease is atherosclerosis, or hardening of the arteries. In this, cholesterol in your blood sticks in your blood vessel wall and forms a thing called an atherosclerotic plaque. Later on, that plaque can rupture, causes a heart attack or a stroke.
What we currently do with to treat and try to prevent cardiovascular disease is we use drugs that are lipid lowering, that reduce the circulating level of lipids like cholesterol in our bloodstream. And that may be a good thing, but at best, that's only likely to prevent around 30% of all heart attacks and strokes.
So what we're working on is to discover additional drugs that can be used with cholesterol to increase what we call their efficacy. So specifically, we're working on drugs which modify proteoglycans. Proteoglycans are protein carbohydrate molecules in your vessel wall, and the carbohydrate component is sticky for cholesterol. You take a statin to lower your cholesterol level, but what we want to do is prevent the cholesterol sticking in your vessel wall. We've been fortunate enough to receive funding from the National Health and Medical Research Council of Australia, the National Heart Foundation of Australia, and Diabetes Australia Research Trust. We have worked our research through from a cellular stage to an animal stage, and of course later on a human stage. We've been able to discover drugs that modify the synthesis of proteoglycans in a vessel wall, lower cholesterol and reduce atherosclerosis in a mouse model. We're a genetically modified mouse, fed a high-fat diet, gets atherosclerosis in about 20 weeks. We give one of our test drugs and we can reduce the atherosclerosis in the mouse by about 50%.
One of the key things here is the link between diabetes and cardiovascular disease. And in fact, often that's not understood. What kills people early with diabetes, if it's not identified and managed, is heart attacks and strokes, that is cardiovascular disease. And it can take 10 to 15 years off the life expectancy of people with diabetes. And that's a major problem in Australia, because now diabetes is the epidemic of the 21st century. We have over 1 million Australians who are known and diagnosed with diabetes, and another 2 million Australians who are at high risk of developing type 2 diabetes in the next 5 years. So the numbers are staggering, and the implications for cardiovascular disease in Australia are staggering.
So the ultimate outcome of our research is a two-product tablet. Tablet containing a statin to lower your blood cholesterol, what I'll call a proteoglycan inhibitor to stop cholesterol from your blood sticking in your blood vessel wall.